back on Urban Today, and with me is my sister Becky, who has come with sports news. So Becky, good morning.
Good morning, Harry.
Tell us about yesterday's match, the mood, and everything that we need to know about that match.
Yesterday was really the long anticipated day everyone was waiting for, and I was here at about 3:30. I was doing Sportswoman, and I had to rush to go watch the game. But unfortunately, the mood wasn't like the previous years, of course, the previous months, because we understand the restrictions, the situation there is because of the pandemic. The mood was really calm. And when I reached home, I watched on my TV set, and I was really, really disappointed. I would say we exhibited a very, very, very bad game. We had a poor performance, but I would credit Halid Lualidwa, who came in the 65th minute and scored in the 85th minute. He gave us a good header from a free kick that was taken by Farouk Mia. Kudos to Halid Lualidwa. This was really unexpected. Before, we were really talking about this team. Why professionals are really taking us first priority, because we have our local best players who are really performing so well. And this is a signal to all the local players that they can really do it. I really saw Bomono, who was brought in the place of Wadada. And I was very disappointed. It was his first debut. I don't know why McKinstry could not play Wadada and bring Bomono in the maybe remaining 20 minutes to have a feel of how you know, the team plays. But it was so bad. And when you talk about Mochivi, he got an injury that is in the first half, no, in the second half. And this justifies what I was talking about yesterday, the artificial turf. They're not used of the turf. Talking about the fans, it was also another problem, because Uganda Cranes is known for having a mammoth crowd at Nambole. But the stadium was really empty, though we saw some few journalists, of course, respecting the social distancing. And I would love to congratulate and commend the few people who went on their statuses, their Facebook pages, and really... yesterday I asked you why your jersey was, but later on I was happy that I saw you, you know, donned in it. And some of the pictures my producer would put on your screen, those of the fans that were supporting at their home, on their social media pages. Please, my producer, just give me those pictures of the fans trying to support the boys. They went on their pages. That is our own
great.
Jarvis.
Right,
he was
good.
Clad in his jersey. That is a sports journalist, Fifi Fiona Pinky, with his
Thank
family.
You, Fifi.
But those are old pictures. As you can see them on your screen, they're old pictures. But, you know, to show that they are still in spirit with the boys. So we have 3 points in the bag. And when you look at the... the table, we are still top on of the league log, and we have to go back to Kenya. That is Uganda with 7 points, Burkina Faso with 4 points, Malawi with 3 points, and South Sudan with no point. So we are seeing the boys in Kenya, and I expect a very, very big change. Ochaya will not be with the team because he has been booked, and we will maybe see Dissan Galiwango come in. And of course, Mochibi is still being monitored because of the injury he got. And we will maybe see Halid Lualidwa come in form.
Looking at yesterday's match, what is it that we Uganda Cranes should have done better to brighten our chances for the future?
I think we needed a more creative midfield with Azira, Mia, and Okello. And I think this is now time for the young generation, you know, to stardom. When you see Okello, Awanyi, Halid Lualidwa, Watambala, when these people are in the field, when they're on the pitch, you saw that the game completely changed. These other people were struggling. I don't understand. They have been in active football at their professional, you know, teams, but they looked like they were struggling. So, personally, this is my analysis. I think we need to see more young blood come on, you know, on form, because we believe they have the talent, and all they need is to believe in themselves. Because seeing Khalid having his first debut on the national team and his scores, he was very confident in the back line. That is really tremendous.
Okay. Do you believe the empty stadium had an impact on
very 90%? Because you know, I've always said, you even find someone. I have a actually, even Lynn Komugisha. Lynn does not know anything about football. But when it is time for Uganda Cranes, you will see her shouting. She'll be, you know, then morale boosting, you know. But she doesn't understand anything. Mm. I bet she only knows Onyango on the team. Mm. But you will see her, you know, giving the support. Nambole would have been full, even besides the restrictions. And even besides the restrictions that we are having right now, if they were at Nambole, they would have felt at home. Because remember, now this is a new home. Chitende is a new home. They have been at Nambole. Maybe they would also have felt a bit at home. But that was a very, very, very big disadvantage, not having fans in the stadium.
We're living in the new normal, and we don't know when the pandemic will stop. Mm-hmm. But the matches have to go on. Mm-hmm. Any lessons to us, the supporters, and to the FUFA?
And to the supporters, they should do what the ladies and the gentlemen on the screen did. Mm. We should support from home. Mm. And I understand that as the UPL is underway in, that is about December 3rd, we should keep calm. I know it will end so soon.
All right. Thanks so much. That was Becky. She was giving us the highlights in the sports world. Thank you so much for being with us on Urban. Let's meet on Monday, same time, same program. Keep it Urban. Bye.